And so, listen. James says, listen, this member is the smallest. But, y'all see that conjunction? It's the smallest, but it's the most dangerous. Are you in here? And so you have to be careful that you are meticulous in your ways, how you handle folk. In other words, you talk to folk the way you want to be talked to. That means, that you ought to be willing to give what you expect from other folk. Because at the end of the day, you're not the only one in the church who deserves respect. Preach, boy. You're not the only one in the church who deserves love. Come on, help me, huh? As a matter of fact, you didn't know what love was until love hung on the plus side. You didn't know what joy was until joy hung on the plus side. You didn't know what peace was until you discovered that you had a relationship with the Prince of Peace. So let's watch this. It's a deadly member, and you want to reach perfection, but you can only do that when you have control over what you say. You see, just because you've lived past 50, okay, y'all. I'm sorry. Okay, I see. Just because you live past 50, it don't mean you can say whatever you want to say. It means that you model appropriate language for the ones who are 50 and below. I know y'all don't like, I'm gonna be right here next Sunday. And so that means, that the old folk ought to teach the young folk. You see, I can't get mad because Kayla don't wash her bathtub if I did not take out time with her to show her how to properly clean her bathtub. Come on, y'all. And that's all James is saying. Yes, but you have to model appropriate behaviors in church. And it's strange, it's messed up, it's jacked up, y'all, when the church looks just like folk who are on the outside. Can I put a pin mark right here, change this right here? Why would folk join New Providence when folk in New Providence don't know how to keep their way straight? I didn't come in church for you to judge me. I came to church to be lifted. Come on, y'all. And so everybody that comes in the church don't have the relationship that you profess to have with him. So just because you can quote 5 or 6 scriptures, you know, the Lord is my shepherd, that's a good one right there. Just because you know Psalm 23, don't mean Psalm 23 gonna get you into heaven. Come on, y'all. You need to know the author of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. So, the Greek word there for the word perfect, the Greek word there simply means mature. It means healthy. You see, y'all thought y'all could leave here and live a perfect life. No, listen, understand. That word perfect does not mean perfect. Because there is none perfect. Here it is. No, not one. So you can't ever be perfect in the perfect sense. But what you can do is strive for the perfection in the active heart. Preach, boy. Listen, in other words, every day I wake up my eyes, God is giving me another opportunity to come closer to him. Because perfect is in him. And if you're striving to be like Jesus, Lord, I want to be like Jesus. It's in my heart. So James says, watch this. James says, mature and healthy folk know how to control their tongue. They know what to say, how to say it, when to say it, Now watch this. This comes with wisdom. Notice that? It comes with wisdom. You see, y'all think just because you have a head full of gray means wisdom. It could mean stress. Talk back to me if you can, huh? It just means that you done went some places you shouldn't have went. You done said some things you shouldn't have said, huh? And God, in his infinite wisdom, y'all, pull out his divine belt and put a whooping on you that nobody could take off of you. So this small member has the power to set the path and the pitch of our lives. In other words, it has the power to set the direction and the tone of our lives. What we say to people affects both parties. Now understand, we're talking about church behavior.
Yeah.
Are you in here? Hopefully you're saved. But if you're in here and you're not saved, when you get saved, come on, y'all, huh? Matter of fact, why don't you exercise the principles before you get saved?
Watch out now.
Are you in here? Thus James describes, if you will, the tongue in verse number 8 as poison. Can I just teach this thing, y'all? Probably we might catch a hoop and holler and get out of here, but y'all just help bear with me. James says the tongue is as poison. Now understand, by way of context, during these times, venom was not just used to describe poison from snakes or even scorpions, but also to describe rust. I expect you to be quiet right there. Watch this here. Poison is used to describe rust. And so James shares, here's the preach, here's the shout, that the tongue has the ability not only to inject and infect with poison, but it has the ability to corrode and to crash your life. Lord have mercy. Now understand, brothers and sisters, rust is continuous and it's constant. And you don't just automatically see rust. You see, there is a building process to rust. Come on, y'all, huh? You see, the only way you can get rusty is when you hang around with rusty folk. You can't smell good hanging around folk who are not clean. And so birds of a feather flock together. Come on, y'all. You can't hang around with men. Come on, y'all, huh? If you ever want to be a millionaire, you hang around with folk who understand how to handle money. If you ever want to live a sinful life, just hang around with boo-boo in your family. You're in the world, but you're not of the world. Huh? Everybody ain't saved in your family. We talked last Sunday about Pookie and Ray Ray. Huh? You know, the Shade Tree cousins. And they gained their knowledge by playing dominoes. Now they can give you a lot of worldly wisdom, but when it comes to this Bible, come on, y'all, huh? They cannot help you. And so rust is continuous, it's constant. And what happens is that once you're infected with the wrong stuff, once you have entertained the wrong thoughts and you've allowed the wrong conversation to get into your spirit, you, here I am right here, y'all, you began to take on the attitude of the person who brought you the trash. And you're walking around wondering why you don't ever smell good. It's been able to dump that trash on you. I wish I had 10 or 20 folk in a building who can testify. This is the day. This is the hour. I'm not nobody's trash can. Don't serve me no junk. Don't serve me no mess. If you ain't coming with the word, get out of my face. Holler. Peace. You have to excuse some folk out of your life. Huh? Because everybody cannot roll with you. Are you in here? You see, you're going somewhere. Huh? And you've discovered that the reason why you can't move as fast as you want to move is because somebody is holding you back. Lord have mercy. Somebody is pulling you back. That's why you have to be careful who you entertain and who you ask to pray for you. Just because they say they're going to pray for you does not mean they're not praying on you. Just because they smile in your face don't mean they didn't bring a knife to church. Just because they give you a hug and a kiss on the cheek, it could be the kiss of death. So you have to walk around with your spiritual eyes open. And when you see the devil coming, you just ease. When you see the devil coming this way, you just move. When you see the devil coming this way, you just turn around and go the opposite way. You're not being mean. You're not being bougie. You just come to church to hear a word from the Lord. I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. And so here it is. Watch this, y'all. Here it is. Can I get out four quick ones? Now, if y'all help me out, we might cut across the fence at three. I want to give you four quick ones, real quick. Four quick ones. Yeah. Four quick ones. Watch this. A troubled tongue, will do at least four things. The tongue prescribes where I go. That's the verse 3 and 4. It prescribes, it provides the prescription, for where I go. It provides a blueprint for the direction that I take. Here it is, you need Bible. Book says that the bit is located in the horse's mouth so as to control where the horse goes. Here it is. The horse don't talk. Come on, y'all. The horse don't hear what you say. The horse's ability to do what it's told to do is based off of the bit that's in the horse's mouth. Come on, talk back to me if you can. And the reason why some folk can't do what God has called them to do is because you're too busy hearing everything else versus what God has already said. Is there anybody in the middle who can testify that you've been guilty? Oh, come on, help me in here. I can testify. I've been guilty of hearing what I want to hear. If it's mess, I like mess. If it's, come on, y'all, if it's trash, I like trash. But how many folk in the building can testify that when it's time for you to hear what God has to say, you have to listen attentively? Because sometimes God speaks in a still, small voice.
Come on, Brady.
Quit thinking that God just speaks to older folk. I said it.